Gonna pray now. Dear Lord, I pray for this chapel that it will honor you, and that I pray that each seventh grade will give all the glory to you by doing their best. And I pray that each of the students here will truly get the message of this chapel. And the message is that we are all children of God, and that we'll all be treated equal and treat each other kindly. Amen.
Hello?
I did so bad.
Good morning, CHA. What you will see in a few moments is a result of prayer and the seventh graders' desire to share with you, that's right, with all of you, what they have learned about how to live a more godly life while here at CHA and elsewhere. The seventh grade boys know that one way to give God glory is by treating each other right. Each of the skits that you'll see was created by all the seventh graders over several days. The boys you see here on stage hope you'll learn to recognize the results of acting ungodly toward each other. The single boy who receives bad treatment truly is a good friend to everyone and is not really picked on or teased like you'll see during the school day. And none of the boys you'll see acting mean truly do or say mean things. They're only acting for your benefit. After each skit, a student and I will come out and ask you questions about what you saw. Our goal is to discover, with your help, where is Christ when Christians are being mean? Okay, hope you enjoy the skits.
So how much bathroom work did you get?
I got like 5 sheets of...
Whoa, stuff. Loser, it's 6 o'clock.
Nice.
Nice. Hey, have you guys seen my binder? It was here just a minute ago.
What binder?
Do you honestly think that we deep down at all truly care about your stupid binder?
I'll answer that. No.
Hey, hold
on, yeah.
Let's go.
Hey, oh! Come on, that's mine. Oh, hey, give it back.
Ahead. Oops.
Come on. That was a gift. Oh. Come on. Give it back.
It slipped.
Oh. Oops.
Right here.
It's a gift.
It's
over here. Oh. Come on, give it back, guys. Stop being mean. Come on. Come on, guys. Stop being mean. Come on,
dude,
give it back.
Stop being. Dude, come on. Take a joke for once. What a nerd.
That party was awesome yesterday.
Yeah. That was so fun.
Yeah. Remember the bungee jumping?
That was awesome.
Mm-hmm. Wait. Which
that
parties?
Was so fun.
Which party?
Oh, it was nothing. Just a little get together.
Yeah. There are only 13 people.
But there's 14 boys in our grade. I wasn't invited.
Exactly. Let's go, guys.
Yeah.
Bye.
Never get invited to those.
I didn't even say anything.
Okay, can someone just raise their hand and tell me what just happened in this last scene? Just hold on a second while we get another mic. Okay, let's go with Elijah back there.
Well, what just happened there was, well, that kid was getting bullied by those other kids. They threw away his math binder, and then they took his hat and were kind of bullying.
Okay, so as Elijah said, he was being bullied in those different ways. So how do you guys think that kid felt? Let's give John a chance. Let's go right here with the ears, with the fluffy ears.
So I think he felt pretty bad that he was getting bullied, and he felt left out.
Okay, very good. Okay, so I think that as well. I think he was very sad about being bullied. And I know that because he was kind of disappointed, and he was just kind of down. Okay, so... So where could we find Christ in this situation? Let's go for a little kid. Anyone? Okay, so John, can you come over here? This little boy?
We can find Christ from God, I think.
Okay. Okay, so... That is absolutely correct. We can find Christ in this situation, but just not in plain sight. God is in each one of us, but he was locked away by the different kids. He was hidden. The kids didn't show kindness to the boy, which they could have, but they didn't, because they locked away Christ in their hearts. And I think that if we keep Christ in our hearts, he's still in us, but it doesn't count. It doesn't really matter, because we're not showing God's love to other kids.
Yeah.
I just want to reiterate what Micah said. That's true. Christ is in our hearts, but we need to allow Christ to work through us. And so each of the boys are Christ followers. But just like you, if we hear a prompting, we need to be kind and we need to be gentle with our friends, not do what they were doing. So that's what Christ is, right? We find Christ in God, but we also need to allow Christ to work through us. So now we're going to get ready for our next skit. Okay, thanks.
Hey, is this spot open?
No, it's taken.
Hey, can I sit here? Please, please, I never get a spot.
Come on. Well, you see, the thing is...
Hey, can I sit here?
Come on. I'll think about it. Hey, open
seat.
Empty
seat.
Yeah. 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 I wanted to sit there. Yeah. Yeah. That was my spot.
Hey,
I wanted to sit there.
Yeah.
Give me some of that.
Imagine
the lunch bell just rang and all the boys
were
on the table.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
That was
delicious.
Yeah.
That was lit.
John. John,
do I need these anymore?
Jonathan. I see you're sitting all by yourself. Oh, do you want to sit by yourself?
No.
Okay. Jonathan, why don't we come back? Let's talk about this. This doesn't look right to me. Come on.
There's no lunch bell.
Aren't the seventh graders great actors? They did a great job, didn't they? So again, as last time, could someone raise your hand and tell us just what happened here? Matthew, I think the girl in the red, I think.
Well, they were at lunch and there were a ton of empty seats, but everybody kept saying that the seats were taken when they really weren't, and when their friends came over, they let them sit in the seats, but not that boy.
Where's it going?
Very good. Good answer.
Yeah, so if that were me, I would feel really bad because I'd think they were my friends and I'd think that they would let me sit there, but obviously not. And then new people came in and they sat there and that would be heartbreaking. So how do you think the boy that was being bullied felt? Right here, yeah.
He's
felt really sad.
Yeah, short but sweet. Okay. I think that's a perfect answer. I think, yeah, he definitely felt sad. And at the end, Mrs. Barron came in and kind of comforted him. And in this situation, if you're being bullied or if the kids are bullying you but they don't realize it, the best thing to do is to go to a parent or to a teacher, because they can help you with that. And if you're feeling sad, then they can comfort you like Mrs. Barron did.
Okay, so the last question, similar to the other one, is where was Christ here? Where was Christ? So we all know they're Christ followers, but where's Christ in this situation? Let's go to, is there a fifth grader up there that knows? Fifth graders, where are you at? Is that you over there? So whoever's pointing at my daughter, I want you to try.
So I think that
God is in the situation by a teacher coming in and making her comfort that person who is feeling very sad.
Yeah, that's perfect. So like the other skit, God was in these kids, but they were just locked away. They just locked Christ away. And that's perfect. Mrs. Barron, I think God led Mrs. Barron to Jonathan, or the boy who's being bullied, and you know, comforted him because he was sad. It's perfect, yeah.
Just kind of curious, anyone else have a thought about where was Christ here? Where's Christ in this situation? How about from one of the second graders, Matthew? How about this young man right here?
Excuse me.
He was in the boy that got bullied.
He's so true, isn't he? It's yeah. Right. Let's give him a hand. That's perfect.
Yep.
He was in the boy who was being bullied. He was in the boy being bullied too. And isn't it, Christ is in all of us, and God loves that boy who is being bullied. God loves the boy who is being ignored. And so why would we treat somebody who God loves in that way? Because God loves each one of us. So God is in all of these boys and all of us as well. Okay, we have one more skit, so we'll be right back.
All right, how should we decide who gets first pick?
Rock, paper, scissors, I guess. All right,
rock, paper, scissors, shoot.
Oh.
All right, Matthew.
Yeah, good choice.
Yeah.
Over here.
Ben. You.
Yes.
No, not you.
What?
Christian.
Yeah.
Come on, pick me.
John.
He knows what he's doing.
The other John.
Over here, come on.
Momo.
Oh, yeah.
come on.
Jared.
Not getting hurt this week.
Yep.
Adam.
You know who it is.
Come on.
All right, there's two guys left.
What?
Will.
I'm here, come on.
Let's go. Yeah.
Micah.
All right, let's go.
Oh.
Wait, you know, sorry. The team's already full.
Yeah, maybe you can play next game.
All right.
Let's play.
This one's like crap. Kick off.
Go, Jared.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Nice.
Oh, hey. Jared, you okay?
No.
Mr. Chavez.
Yeah, Mr. Chavez got hurt.
My leg.
Oh no.
Well, that didn't last long.
And Mr. Chavez.
Oh wait, hey, we're down a player. Hey, we're down a player. Can we have him?
Yeah, let's talk to him.
Hey, Jared got hurt and we need someone else to play.
Yes.
Wait, just because Jared got hurt.
Finally!
Alright, guys, huddle.
Alright, guys, team huddle.
Remember, don't guard Jonathan.
You run it, go. You run it, go. You run it, go. You run it, go. And you just get open.
I got the QB.
Alright, ready?
I got deep.
Alright. Over here, I'm open. Come on. Matthew.
Oh, no.
Hey, good try. We'll get it next time.
Let's try.
All right, guys, same play. Same play. You guys got that?
Yeah.
Come on, I'm open.
Sorry, though.
Ready? Hey. Over here. John. Oh. Hey, don't worry about it. No, we'll get it next time. Don't worry. All right, guys, if we don't score here, we lose, okay? All right. The secret play, you guys all remember it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, let's go. Ready? Hi.
Come on.
They're going to John.
Throw it to me.
Dude, come on. Oh, yeah.
No, if you would have called that, we would have won.
You
ruined
it.
Ow.
Wait,
wait.
Great group of actors, aren't they? Very believable. I'm sure that doesn't happen, right? So again, can somebody sort of tell us what just happened here? Let's go for, is that sixth grade up there? All right, so Matthew, there's a girl in striped shirt, long, there you go.
They were picking teams for football and he didn't get picked, and then this one person got hurt, and then they put Jonathan on the team just because they didn't have one player.
Yeah, that's.
And then they didn't throw it to him.
Yeah. And then when he did get thrown the ball, that he dropped it.
And then they kept calling him. And then they kept, getting mad at him.
Yeah, so. Kind of shows that when the quarterback, he threw to his friends and they didn't catch it, they said, oh, it's okay, it's okay. But when the boy that was getting bullied, when he dropped it, everyone kind of booed him and was kind of mean to him. And I feel like the boy, he didn't feel like he was actually on the team. He was kind of invisible and the players didn't like him at all. So if how do you think he would feel? Let's go, girl in the black shirt. Yeah.
He felt really bad about himself because he couldn't play. It's like he's left out. He's actually in the team, but then he doesn't get a chance to, like, score a goal.
Exactly, he felt left out. And especially when he saw all the other guys who missed the ball, they dropped it. They were like, yeah, that's okay, you're fine. But when he dropped the ball, how did they treat him? Bad, right? They're like, oh, come on, what's the matter? You can't catch it. So yeah, he definitely got a double whammy there, right? So again, just like last time, I think we're getting used to this, right? Where is Christ here? We're all Christ followers, aren't we? We come to the school to learn about Christ, to understand how to allow him to work in our lives more, and even to practice allowing Christ work in our lives more. But where is Christ? Let's try, who else do we have up there? Maybe Helena, do you want to try?
So I think because the quarterback was nice, like he said, like, I'm sorry that the team is full, but I think it wasn't like it was like half-hearted. Mm-hmm. He was kind of sorry. Mm-hmm. But I think the boy felt like no one liked him, and so he felt like they thought he was invisible. Mm-hmm. And so the people could have been more Christ-like. Like, it's okay. Mm. You'll get better.
Mm. Right. That's a good point. He started to show Christ-likeness by kind of apologizing, but yeah, maybe it wasn't really, really heartfelt. Yeah. How about on this side? Where's Christ here? Where's Christ here? Is that you, Sage? All right. Sorry, Matt. There you go.
When he got, like Kalina said, kind of when he got to be in it, but someone else got hurt, though.
So, yeah. So Christ was in, help me with that, I'm sorry.
He got to play after.
Mm. Mm. Right, so things worked out. He did get to play for a little bit, too, right? So that's a good thing. That's very good. What about the idea that the team's being even? Like, no, we don't. Yeah, we have enough kids on the team. We don't need to have one more. Why don't you just sit and wait? Is that showing, you know, loving kindness to your classmates? Nobody? Yeah, no, not really, right? Because it doesn't matter. As long as your friend gets to play, that's important, okay? That's important. So if you see someone out that you wanted to join your game, whether it's Foursquare or football or something, if the teams are uneven, that's okay, right? That's not a big deal. Okay, so in just a moment, each of the students are going to come out and share some of their reflections about what they did and how they act. And they even have some challenges for each and every one of you. Okay, so they'll be right back out.
So, hi, I'm John. And
I'm Ben.
And we were in the locker scene bullying the boy who got bullied. And
okay, so so we hit his binder, and we started grabbing his hat and tossing it around. And instead of doing that, we should have let his binder alone. And if we'll grab the hat, then we should have given it back to him instead of waiting for him to get upset.
And we also took the empty seats at the lunch table, which were his seat, the boys' seats. And we could have made a point and just said, hey, you can have my seat, or I won't take your seat. I'll just eat standing up. And that would have been or gone to another table. That would have been a nice way to show that we cared for him. And during the football skit, we could have stopped him when they said don't guard Jonathan, because that was really mean. We could have stood up for Jonathan. And
when they were choosing the teams, we could have said that that he could be on our team, and that we would just have an extra player. So, yeah.
Thank you.
Hi, my name's Will. In the skits, I bullied a boy by taking his hat and making fun of him. I also didn't care when he was getting bullied throughout every single scene. Now, in real life, I wouldn't have taken his hat or not cared about how he was being treated. I would tell those students who are acting mean to stop and to think about what they were doing. I encourage each of you to trust what Proverbs 19 says, which is that when we are kind to each other, we show kindness to our Lord. Thank you.
In the lunchroom skit, each of us were pretty mean. I shoved my classmate away, and I put something on his chair just to make fun of him. Each of us acted in a way that God does not each of us acted in a way that does not show God's love.
We all are called to show God's love to each other. The Apostle John writes that we all need to love each other. We can do this by being kind to each other.
I'm using that.
What I did was I didn't really pay any attention when my teammates were saying that they were going to leave him out of the game. I should have suggested that we let him play, even if it makes our teams unfair. Then our team was harsh towards him. When he dropped passes, they were mean to him. But when other members of the team dropped passes, they were kind, saying sorry, and that was a good pass. These aren't things we should be doing to our classmates, even if they aren't exactly our best friends.
Okay, so I was in the lunchroom scene, and I didn't pay much attention to the bullied boy until he sat on the banana, and we all laughed at him, which was mean, if you've ever felt that. It's kind of like all the attention on you. And I was also in the football scene. I encouraged not throwing to him, and I encouraged discouraging him by, you know, booing him and being mean to him. And in real situation in the lunchroom, I'd let him sit by me, or if he went and sat alone at a different table, I'd go sit by him. And in the football scene, I would, you know, not discourage him and say, it's okay, you can get better. This is not the only time you're gonna drop a catch. And, you know, encourage the kid that was bullied.
We were in the lunchroom, and when the boy was getting bullied, we just sat there and watched. We should have told everyone to stop being unkind. Anyone who just sits and watches are just like kids who are actually saying mean things. If we see this happen, we will do what we can and stop it. How about you?
In the lunchroom skit, the kid was getting bullied. We just watched him getting bullied and did nothing. My character was doing nothing when this happened. I should have standed up to him. What would you do in this situation?
In these skits that you saw, we were all bullying a boy in maybe ways some of you have been treated. Or maybe you were the person bullying someone, or maybe even the kid who stood by and did nothing while someone was getting bullied. Whichever situation you are in, you must always show God's love. Unlike all of us did, showing God's love can lift someone up and even make someone feel better in a bad situation. In one of these skits, when the person being bullied wanted to sit next to me in the lunchroom, instead of me saying, oh yeah, you can sit here, I tried to come off easy by not saying anything and making excuses to not let him sit down next to me. But the truth is, actions can hurt just as much as words can. So you should always try your best to not only use your words to lift people up, but also your actions.
Hi, I'm Noah. And we're the captains in a football skit, and we were trying to avoid picking the boy to be on our team. This is obviously not the best thing to do. Even though someone is not the best at something, does not mean we need to make them feel bad. It may not look like much, but we know that ignoring someone can ruin their day. And by selecting someone to be on the team, and even throwing the ball to him will make them very happy. Oh, the golden rule says, do unto others as you would do to them unto you.
What we should have done was let him play even if the teams were uneven, because friendship is more important than a football game. I was also in the locker scene, and I was the one who hid the binder. That is a simple act that makes me a bully. I also watched while the other kids took his hat and teased him by not giving it back.
Do you think by just standing there and watching them makes me a bully too? Of course it does. If this really happened, I would have not hit his binder and I would have stopped the bullying and tried to help the boy out. If you are a captain, if you are captains on the team, we hope that you do not exclude anyone.
Drop the mic.
Hello, my name is Jonathan. As you know, I was the boy in the skits who you just saw was teased and excluded. The guys were only acting and I really wasn't picked on. We were all pretty good friends. We put together these skits to show you that even if it seems fun or feels okay to tease or pick on someone, it isn't right. For those who may think it is okay to be mean because it is funny or it makes me laugh, remember that God loves the person you are teasing. God loves the person you exclude as well. God loves the person you ignore. So, my classmates and I would like to ask you, if God loves everyone, why can't you? Thank you for your kind attention. Mr. Chavez will dismiss you back to class.
Well, CHA, thank you so much for allowing us to present what we've been learning about how to act kind, how to show God's love, how to show Christ's love to everybody. Let me close in prayer and then I'll dismiss. Just bow your heads with me. Heavenly Father, thank you for the words. Thank you for the actions. Thank you for the hard work of these seventh grade boys. I pray that you continue to move powerfully in each of their lives. And Lord, I thank you for the words that you gave them to that we can share with the CHA school. And I pray that these words find a nice place in each of their hearts and allow that to come back and remind them how to be more Christ-like each and every day. In your son's name I pray, amen. Amen. Okay, so I guess the younger grades can go first, or maybe the sixth graders, seventh graders, you could be dismissed.